Hi again, Doug Stuman with IT Creations. And finally, we have an HPE system that supports the third generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors, the 1U HPE ProLiant DL360 Gen 10 Plus. All the Gen 10 servers without the Plus support AMD EPYCs or Intel Xeon Scalable processors from either the first or second generation. This 1U server is on the Intel side, and the Plus means it supports the third generation Intel Xeons, which have a completely different socket, so first or second generation CPUs are not an option. Shall we? Can honestly say I thought I had one of these systems lined up last year for a demo unit, and then HPE ghosted me. I'm sure it was probably me and not them. Intel's third gen CPUs offer significantly more, with up to 40 cores, PCIe 4.0, support for more and faster memory, plus PCIe 3.0 compatibility. Third generation AMD EPYC processors with up to 64 cores, PCIe 4.0, and other stuff also have a place in the Plus lineup. But here we're talking Intel, with a zero on the end of the product name, like the HPE ProLiant DL360 Gen 10 Plus. You get an Intel CPU-based system with a 5 on the end, like say the DL365 Gen 10 Plus, you get AMD EPYCs for processing power. Easy, right? I mean, compared to some other companies' naming convention. Diane! Ah, wow, it's been rather dry lately. Basic storage options include either an 8-bay chassis with 2.5-inch hot swap drives, plus an optional media bay that can be converted to hold two additional drives, or a 3.5-inch drive bay configuration with four hot swap drive bays up front, plus an optical drive. The 3.5-inch drive bay chassis only supports SAS or SATA backplane. However, there are a few storage options for the 2.5-inch chassis, dependent on choice of backplane. The 2.5-inch drive bay chassis supports SATA, SAS, plus U.2 or U.3 NVMe drives, and the same for the media bay options. You can get all 10 NVMe U.2 or U.3 drives up front with a tri-mode U.3 backplane, plus an optional 2-bay drive cage in the media bay. Also a combination of two NVMe U.3 drives with the rest SAS or SATA, and then there's all SATA or SAS. Are you interested in the HPE ProLiant DL360 Gen 10 Plus server? Because if you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system listed on our site, or one that you configure that's valued at $5,000 or more. It's easy. Just hit that link to start shopping, and when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. Save $500 off. Just think of all the cases of beer you can get with that. Just don't drink and deploy. HPE's fairly new tri-mode controllers provide support for the Gen 10 servers and feature advanced RAID controls for SAS, SATA, and NVMe devices, plus 8 GB of cache. They can operate in mixed mode, combining RAID and host bus adapter HBA features simultaneously. All these configurations also support an embedded storage controller, providing RAID capabilities of up to 14 SATA drives or 2 NVMe SSDs. So perhaps a smart storage RAID controller with SAS in the standard front bays and NVMe using an optional HD cage in the media bay. Also supported is Virtual RAID on CPU, or VROC, which is an enterprise-grade hybrid RAID solution that includes a small hardware key. It can RAID up to 8 direct-attached NVMe SSD drives with a 2-processors configuration using the 2 PCIe 4.0x8 slots on the system board. There's also an option for 2 more if you want to add an additional 2 drive bays through the optional media bay. The 3.5-inch chassis is listed as just SATA or SAS drives and only has a single backplane associated with that configuration. Yes, you will need an HD RAID controller for SAS drive formats. A maximum storage capacity of up to 153 terabytes on the 2.5-inch system is possible using SAS or NVMe drive types, but you could get up to 200 terabytes with a SATA implementation. That would also be incorporating 2 additional drives in the media bay for a total of 10 up front. In general, you get significantly less storage with a 3.5-inch bay chassis. For both, an optical drive is optional. Our chassis doesn't have the optical drive bay, nor do we have an optional drive cage. A control panel on the right side of the 2.5-inch drive bay chassis has a USB port with a dedicated integrated lights out port for management right beside it. Above that, a power on button with LED, plus a health status LED, NIC status LED, and a unit ID button LED. The 4-bay 3.5-inch chassis also has a control panel right above drive bay number 4 on the right. The far left can be outfitted with the optional optical drive bay tray. There's also an optional System Insight display panel that pops out with the press of a button and provides more granular information on individual components installed, which is great for troubleshooting. The SID panel is available on both the 8-bay and 4-bay chassis, but you will lose the ILO service port on the 2.5-inch chassis if you use this option. On the back of the system, there are up to three PCI slots arranged across the top of the chassis with dual redundant PSUs on the far right, supporting 500-watt, 800-watt, and 1600-watt options. Next to the PSUs, a VGA port and an OCP 3.0 mezzanine card slot next to that. The OCP card comes with several connection speed and port options, including up to 200 gigabit Ethernet. You could also use a NIC in one or two of those PCI slots. There's a serial port knockout next to that, and then the USB 3.0 slots and the dedicated ILO management port. That management port on the back of the system grants access to HPE's integrated Lights Out Advanced for health management, remote management, service alerting and reporting, all from a standard web browser. There's also ILO mobile for smartphones and tablets for at-chassis management of the system. HPE OneView takes it a step further and is a comprehensive management program for multiple servers, providing asset overview, provisioning, updating and integrating compute storage, and networking. Another optional feature is HPE InfoSight for servers offering a predictive maintenance utility combining cloud-based machine learning with ILO and active health systems. It's kind of like that Tom Cruise movie. No, not Maverick. Minority Report, where they predict who's going to commit a crime before it even happens and then arrest them. HPE InfoSight kind of works a little differently, but maybe it's not that similar. Inside the chassis, we see the somewhat larger sockets for the third generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors. This platform supports processors from the Platinum, Gold, and Silver CPU categories. Bronze is no more with the Ice Lake series, which kind of makes it easier, I suppose. I will mention that only the Platinum processors support up to 40 cores, while Gold has up to 32 cores and Silver a maximum of 20 cores. There are also various suffixes added to the processor model numbers, which denote their targeted capabilities. All three support PCIe 4.0 for vastly improved throughput for I/O and NVMe devices, plus each processor has 8 memory channels to work with. Memory speeds are dependent on the processor and memory configuration. In the DL360 Gen 10 Plus, each processor supports 16 memory module slots with 2 DIMMs per channel for a total of 32 active memory module slots with both processors installed. Only Gold and Platinum processors provide memory speeds of 3200 megatransfers per second, while Silver will provide a top speed of 2666 megatransfers per second. Registered, load-reduced, and Intel persistent memory modules can be installed. Persistent memory modules are paired with either RDIMM or LRDIMMs. Third-generation CPUs enable twice the memory compared to the previous generation at 6 terabytes per CPU. That said, this platform is limited to 4 terabytes per CPU for up to 8 terabytes of memory at capacity using a combination of DRAMs and persistent memory modules. In the event of a power failure, an HPE Smart Storage battery is required to back up write cache data on the HPE Smart Array Gen 10 RAID controllers, providing just enough juice to power the system until data can be transferred from cache to flash. The CPUs and memory modules are cooled by a bank of hot swap high-performance dual rotor fan modules. Easy as pie to replace them in the event of a failure, as long as you don't have the cover off for more than 60 seconds. There are a few PCI slot options for the primary riser, including 2x16 PCI 4.0 slots, or a single PCIe 4.0x16 slot paired with a x8 slot. There's also an M.2 riser option, again with a x16 slot and x8 slot, plus hardware RAID support for 2 M.2 drives for fast boot of the operating system. You could also go with a dual M.2 PCIe card in one of the PCIe slots if you don't get the M.2 riser option. The secondary riser supports a single PCIe 4.0x16 slot with either a low profile or full height option. If you go with the full height option, that will take out slot number 2 on the primary riser. With the compute power of this system, high-speed I/O NICs are a good move. I will mention, this system doesn't have any integrated Ethernet ports for network connectivity, aside from the dedicated management port. You will need either an OCP mezzanine card, PCI-based I/O card, or a combination of the two for network connectivity. This platform will take a single NVIDIA Turing-powered T4 Tensor Core card in one of those PCI slots, offering compute acceleration and support for distributed environments. As you can see, the HPE ProLiant DL360 Gen 10 Plus server is a definite high-performance powerhouse with Intel's third-generation processors. You know, it's funny, because every time a new processor comes out, we're like, oh, look at that, so many cores, and the clock speed. A few months later, honeymoon's over, and we're wondering why there weren't more cores, more PCI lanes, just more. Technology. Anyways, check out itcreations.com for this server and many others. that we can configure to your specifications and test it so you can put it into action the moment it arrives. Who wants to deal with all those little boxes anyways? By the way, I placed a few links in the description below and right there. If you want more information on this server or just want to see something else that IT Creations has to offer. Spoiler alert, full systems, processors, memory, storage, and other obscure parts. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.